Hello, viewers. Super DT here. Can you hear me? I'm in the Shadow Realm. Can you help me escape? Yes, this is a fake live stream. This is the beginning of my ASMR channel. ASMR Super GT. Hello viewers, Super GT here. And no, that wasn't my voice you could just hear, that was someone else. Right, okay, let's get straight into it. Let's go. We know the deal, you know the deal. Three races, can you hear me? Hopefully you can. Should be able to. Yeah, okay. Three new races, an interesting one because you've got a new track this week. The Tokyo Expressway South Inner Loop. There's two tracks they've added. This is one of them, which I think is actually the better one. On that picture, you can see sort of the triple right-hander. And you get to that quite early in the lap. So central, that is like chaos central right there. Okay, we'll start with Sakazuka. As normal, we go for race B because that starts in like less than 10 minutes. Then move on to race C. And maybe at some point we'll do race A. I don't want to do it, but be cool. Getting in there early with a fiver. What's up, Be Cool? Thank you for tuning in. Thank you everyone for tuning in. Yeah, so the lap times, let's have a look quickly, because for this one I've just done one lap. I did one lap. So 106, so whatever. Which link is your paper? Should be the one in the description. Pestilence, good to see you again, mate. I hope you got. Hopefully the little lesson there might have made you a little bit quicker. Around this one, I did about four laps. I was actually pretty pleased because I'm like second on my friends list, and I've got so many friends. Look, I've got 97 friends. These are my best friends here. Actually, 96, because one of them is me. Obviously, I'm not my own friend. Still a second, or more than a second off of what Key's done, but second on the list, not too bad. And then race C, again, fairly good performance, 54.6. And this one is just dominated by the Volkswagen GTI, VGT, open bracket, GR.3, close bracket. As we can see, if you go on top 10, it's just all 10. So this car is ridiculous. It's an interesting race though, and I mean, to begin with, we'll try one in the Volkswagen, but then we'll see what we can do in other cars, see if we can actually beat the Volkswagen. Okay, let's get on with it, shall we? First race here at Suzuka. I'm just going to go with a new wagon, the easiest wagon to begin with, which is actually, that's criminal because I don't have a paint. Let's have a look. I must get a paint first. Right. But thank you for joining me. Hello, welcome everyone. Monday evening. Well, it is for me in the UK, but it depends where you are in the world. Maybe it's Tuesday morning. Maybe it's Monday midday. Maybe it's Monday in the afternoon. Probably you're still in America and you're still at work. That might well be a possibility. What am I doing? Car livery. Oh, what am I doing? I've got 5 minutes. Italy, Alfa Romeo 4C GR3. Anything good? Oh god. I'm gonna add it to my collection. Possibly use it one day. These are the ones I like. The more simple racing-inspired liveries. These are normally what I go for. Not the anime. I mean, just one like that. I mean, that's nice. Simple, very simple, but nice. We like that here. We like that. Congrats on over 150,000. Many thanks. Yes. Incredible achievement, really. I just never thought I'd get that far. I mean, just thank you to everyone for being part of it. Onwards to 1,000 trillion, obviously. That's our next. We're going to be the first person to get the 1,000 trillion play button. Have a quick look. I'll do. Okay, we'll just change it now. Oh, wait. 4C... Yes, you're right. What am I doing? I need to be... Okay, well, one day when I use the 4C in Group 3, then I'll have... I have some liveries. Okay, right. Group 4.
Peggy, 18.
What an idiot. Right, let's have a quick look for a good one. Just one will do. Love that one. Okay, that'll have to do. What even is that? We're going with it. That's a Peggy 18. Clone of sheep. What? I love these random news articles on there. Give me my love livery. There we go. Yeah, YouTube Rewind. God, where do we start with that? Like, first off, it's like Will Smith at the beginning. Like, I know he does have a YouTube channel, but there's still a problem with that, really, because you know he made his fame on TV, and I'd say that for anyone who's rich and famous, could make a transition to YouTube because they can just pay for people to edit videos, people to do everything for them. Obviously, they're going to be on the camera doing the acting, but yeah, I mean, you got him. If I could control YouTube, I would want Fortnite. It's like, oh god, you see where this is going already. Don't do this. So, I mean, okay, yeah, I wasn't on Rewind. Not that I was expecting to be on it, but probably a good job. It got like 80% dislikes. And then you got Ninja, who's actually a Twitch streamer in the majority. Jaden Hayes, 666 laps on the new track. Only 666? I mean, I would like to do an endurance on it. So you can't actually do 200. You can't actually do 600. You can only do 200 as a max. But I do like the track, and I do plan to do endurance on it. So, well, I suppose we could do four races, which total 666 laps. Why not? And then you got what's he called? Yeah, Ninja. So it did make the sense, the transition to him, because if you watch it, some people are talking. I think it's Marcus Brownlee and someone else. I don't know the name. So they just say something very reasonable, and then it cuts to Ninja at the front of the bus, and he's like, "Quit horsing around." It's like they didn't even say anything. It's Hugh Hattrick. Thanks for your tips. I got down to 47.6, second up at Major Race Short last week. It's hammer time. It is hammer time indeed. Let's have a couple of good ones here. And yeah, that Maggiore race was actually very enjoyable. Pestilence! There he is. So Pestilence actually ours last week. This is an interesting one. How much would you charge for 2 hours of 2 hours of tuition for them? I was like, oh, and $40. I wasn't really serious about it. And well, he messaged me later and going, no, I was actually serious. Can I do the 2 hours? And I was like, okay. We actually did 2 hours the other day. And well, thanks so much for the donation. I mean, I always felt that. I've got a guide on how to get fast, but I think sometimes maybe like a one-to-one can be a good way to get fast, and hopefully it's worked out for you, mate. But it's something that I'm looking at, because a lot of people are always asking. They're always asking like, when are you going to make the video on how to get quick on this game, also on Forza. So I made it on Forza 6, and to be fair, like, the Forza 6 tips do carry over to Forza 7. You could just watch the Forza 6 video and it pretty much tell you how to be quick at Forza 7, but it might be an idea to make another one, and for GT Sport, because I haven't actually made one yet, because there are quite a lot of little tricks. Because Hyperdrive, yo, welcome along, Hyperdrive, thank you for joining once again. Good to see you, my friend. I can't even remember what I was saying now. But yeah, I was actually, someone left a comment and I read it, because they were talking about one of my old videos from pretty much a year ago. They went, "God, you've improved so much." And I watched it and I was like, "Oh my God, I am awful." When I played this game, look at my old videos from this game. I was shocking. Well, I was okay, but. As soon as you did get faster, and it was good fun. Good to hear that, mate. But yeah, just keep practicing. Like, getting faster on these games can be a tedious process sometimes. It's like constant lapping, learning. Sometimes it's not always fun. Just to be fun is just going into a race, doesn't matter, just do your best and see what happens. But sometimes you do need to study replays and hammer out laps and not get frustrated when you make a mistake. And so, I mean, the main thing I was talking about Pestilence with was breaking points. Going into a corner, trying to break consistently, trying to accelerate out of the corner at the right kind of at the right time, and just keeping the car not from spinning through the turn. Like, as soon as the car's sliding, like, control it. Get the car under control, don't slide. If you hear the tyre squealing, something's wrong. Okay, oh, Wi-Fi password, there he is. He's in fourth. And what is his connection? He's got a full bar, he's actually got 5-bar connection. Wow. He had a 1-bar connection not long ago. Now he's gone up. I found Tishney's videos helpful with pace, says Scott Mansfield. Thanks, Scott. And yes, always, I'll definitely recommend Tishney. See his name on the screen there. Tishney Racing. Very quick guy, probably the quickest in Britain, or one of the quickest. And he's just started a series called Racing School. So he's breaking down everything in the game and telling you how to get quicker, basically. So definitely have a look at that. Don't watch my videos, I'm rubbish. Right, is it four laps? This isn't going to be as popular this race this week. I think everyone's going to be going for race C. This combination has been done quite a few times already, but I'll take it, you know, I'll take it. He doesn't like a bit of Suzuka. Wi-Fi password is still there. The leader's pulling away. Taking it back, Wi-Fi boy. God, the leaders already are a huge gap. Need to focus here a little bit. Still there, he's going to have the slipstream. So this Thursday we've got the Fortune Island DLC on Horizon 4, which I'll be giving a go, see what it's like. Oh god, I'm late. Oh no! Okay, that's a really bad lap. Drop right off the front. Bit rusty, but it is the first race. Why does no one use the WRX? Well, I mean, these days people just stick to the best cars, which is exactly what I'm doing. Route 4 has been quite bad for that, I found. People often sticking to a very limited amount of cars. In Group 3, WRX is popular, or at least it gets used. Oh, I can't read that at the moment. Cheers, Scott, for the £2. I can't read the message though, sorry. Just lost like half a second in that sector. I only watch your vids to offer emotional support, of which I need quite a lot sometimes. Oh, he's gone for it. I did break a little bit early there, actually. Oh, he's right there. Focusing enough here. Wi-Fi password's got away. Oh, did he spin? Right, nearly. Okay, I've actually caught up with Wi-Fi there. Let's at least get back to third. Where I've started. Oh, bloody hell. I'll read that one in a moment, Pestilence, but thank you once again. Oh, second place is off, nearly. Okay, we could still get second here if we don't bottle it completely. he's wide again. Something good is going to happen here. First place is long gone, but second is on. Oh, Wi-Fi is opening up the inside. The Audi is a little bit better in the line compared to the Alpha. Pushed him wide. Oh no, don't like a hurt. Oh, it's so frustrating when you're the third person in a pack and the guy in the middle of the pack makes so many mistakes. So you're losing track of the guy in the second there. Just for the fiver, Jerry. Oh man, I'm just not concentrating enough here. We've got 4 second penalty. He's bump drafting me, okay. It's entirely your fault that good stuff has turned into my catchphrase. I'm invading people's vocabulary now. Good stuff. Yeah, like, the thing is, I don't really notice I'm saying these things, but I guess I am. I think I say so quite a lot. I say that too much. There are little phrases and sayings that I do say too often, and people do pick up on that in the comments. Come on, let's get that third. I'm not going to get second now, I don't think, unless he really screws up. Right in that slipstream, and he's not getting the slipstream of seconds. So I won't go for it here, but there might be a chance into the final chicane or 130R. It's on. It is on, mate. Got him. 130R, baby. Oh, perfectly done. Oh, he's wide. That move is never going to work, mate. Plus, you've got a penalty, so it's kind of pointless. Okay, I'm going to get third. Bit of a rubbish race, but I suppose we made up for it at the end there. Got back to where we started. Wi-Fi password? It's James. Get in there, Lewis. I love Wi-Fi passwords. He's a good lad. I seem to race him quite often, you know. Pestman said, watched Eerie's video, and he's basically the David Attenborough of GT Sport Commentation. He should have rammed you off, to be honest. Yeah, it felt a bit like that. I remember that video. I don't think it was too close, though, to be honest. I don't think he was going to go for it. I've learned from Super GT to not go into turns with full power on. It depends on the turn, but sometimes like half throttle can really control the car for a turn. Like using the throttle to control the car is something you do have to learn. Okay, well, a bit of a rubbish race. I wasn't really concentrating fully. But at least we got back to where we started in third. Could have been second if I was a bit quicker. And the Irish guy in there kept making mistakes, but he didn't. Okay, this is it. Race C. This is the important one. So I actually, when I first set my qualifying time, I did it on hard tyres, but you can actually race on soft, which is worth a couple of seconds a lap. So don't make that mistake. You can race on soft tyres or medium. So first off, we're going to go over the Volkswagen. Then we'll give a couple of other cars a go, see what works. Henry Carter, I'm always like 0.8 or 1.2 seconds off your lap time. You think a wheel would help me close the gap? Well, I mean, I'm on a controller, so obviously I can set the times I can set on a controller. But I do think that as much as I like to use the controller, I would always say that the wheel is a little bit better on this game, because the main thing is coming out of corners when you're getting on the throttle. It's really hard to balance the steering on a controller with the throttle. So obviously, if you're turning really sharp and you get on the throttle, the car will just spin. So on a wheel, you can just hold, the steering wheel at a certain angle. On the controller, it's really hard to move the stick the exact amount. And obviously on the pedal, it's a little bit easier than the button, but or than the trigger. I say a wheel is just a little bit easier to be smoother, and that helps a lot in this game. So I would say it helps, but I wouldn't immediately expect to be quicker. It would still take time to learn. But thank you, Henry Carter, for the $10 there, mate. It's really nice of you. In which stream does he dab? Oh, I've dabbed in a few. I can't remember exactly what ones though. Okay, make sure I'm on soft tires. Edmonault, thanks for making the videos you do. I used to be a wall riding noob, but now I have some basics like attacking and defending a position. Good stuff, man. We're converting them one by one, the ramming wall riders. But yeah, good to hear. I mean, I do get people commenting saying, "Oh, but wall riding is fun and ramming's well fun." It's like, okay, but racing properly and achieving a good lap time or having a good race, even if you lose the race, just having a good race can be just as fun. Well, it should be more fun, really. So yeah, good to hear that. So this car, you need to change gear pretty much where the big red one is in the rev gauge, just above that. So about 80% across the rev gauge is where you need to shift. So this might be your first time looking at this track. It's an interesting one, but I actually really like it. I'm a big fan. Yeah, for anyone who uses buttons for throttle and brake, I mean, if you can be quick with that, then you're doing very well. But I'll suggest that, at least for the throttle, you need to have a modulation. You need to be able to put on half throttle or a little bit of throttle rather than 100% or 0%. That's very useful. So I definitely recommend changing over to using the triggers. With the brake, it's not too bad because normally I'm just mashing it all the way down. But I still think it'll be useful for that as well. Okay, that was an okay lap, probably, but be a 156.0, I'd imagine. Let's have a look. No, don't sell yourself so short, mate. 155.1. So that's half a second off my PB. Let's see if we can go any better. It's a weird car, this. Look at the interior. Very strange. Really easy to get penalties around here. All four was beyond the line and just gets you get an instant penalty. So don't do that, obviously. Ah, sitting inside, really easy to do. What buttons do I use for gear changes? Yeah, so I use X for down. X for up gears and square. Well, I had to actually look at the controller then, I forgot what the buttons were. And square for down gear. Paul Connolly. On Christmas Day, eat, drink, GT Sport, repeat. To be fair, I probably will. Pick up some easy wins against the Christmas noobs. I don't know what I'm doing on Christmas Day, to be honest. Have to see. Christmas Day live stream. Cheers, Paul. That's a good one. It's a tricky circuit, this. Very, very tricky. Obviously, you've got the walls. There's no runoff. You go wide, you die. It's just death or nothing. Yeah, get some cheap wins against all the casual noobs on Christmas Day. But I don't suspect many people will be getting this game on Christmas Day. There will be some, of course. It has been out for over a year. Last Christmas would have been the real Christmas to do it. Oh, that's my word. This has donated £6 too. Hey Super GT, I don't really know what to put in this message. Well, thank you very much for the donation. You're speeches, I suppose, but thank you very much. Oh, that's a point. My 50. Wait, let's reload that. I don't think my rating's actually that high. Yeah, 84 out of 99. Okay, so that's why I'm not against really top players here. No offense to anyone who is here, but... No! Didn't load. God damn it. Close application. Pestilence, for those of us without families, here's a tenner. For Xmas live stream. Yeah, I suppose I could be the family for the day. We have the Super GT live stream family. How about that? But thank you so much once again, Pestilence. Oh god, it's so annoying when that happens. So annoying. Super GT. You should do a donation stream to help out all those poor souls sent to the Shadow Realm. Should I set up a charity? Just £1 can bring back someone from the Shadow Realm for one day, just to see their family, then have to go back again. Classic Gran Turismo Sport, eh? Not working. Ah, oh, God. Thank you so much. Wasting half an hour of everyone's time, game. I suppose... Wait... Yeah, we do this race. I suppose that's only 7 minutes away. We'll do this race. That should take us to this race again. Okay, we'll do that. This is the Greddy Fugu Z. So this is the car in last week's DLC. Or update, whatever you want to call it. Update, I suppose. It's not DLC because you don't... Downloadable content. Well, I suppose technically it is downloadable content. You're not paying for it. But you download it and it is content. So yes, DLC. Get this man some pizza. It is my birthday later this week, actually, on Friday. And I know what I'm getting. It begins with 5 and it ends in Guy's Cheeseburger. Yes, that's right. 5 Guy's Cheeseburger. Hassan Osman has donated €2. Any tips? Bought a wheel today. Her main thing really, just obviously plug it in, turn the game on. Obviously, those are the main tips. But this is kind of the same tips for everyone. Just practice, watch the top times, see what they do. Practice your breaking points, get your breaking points right. Be smooth, be gentle on the throttle, come out the corners. Don't get the car to rotate and spin. There's another one there. Sir Fluffy says that moment when the game itself sends itself to the Shadow Realm. It does it all the time. It just wants to send itself. But yeah, thank you very much, Sir Fluffy. But yeah, just general tips for Gran Turismo is, I suppose it's true of most racing games, just watch the top players, so watch the replays. And of course, once you've watched the replay, restart the game. So, close application. Oh, where is it? Close application and then go back in, because otherwise the game will crash. You'll get that blue screen thing. Watch what the top players do. Be smooth, be consistent, keep the car. Don't let the car rotate too much. And don't get sent to the show. How about you wish for a wheel for Christmas, Kappa? Love the streams, really hoping to see you on a wheel at some point and see what you could do. Also, you're probably tired of this, but why aren't you already on a wheel? So many thanks Pepsi for the €20 there, mate. It's really nice of you. Well, I am actually buying a wheel. I bought the sim rig. The wheels come in, the rig's come in. In fact, well, I mean, one of the wheels is here. Many of you might have seen this. It's the Fanatec McLaren wheel. So I have the wheel, I don't have the pace yet, I don't have the rig yet. I have the racing chair, which is, I can go and get that in a second. Eros donated fiver. The Superus GTS hath arrived, PogChamp. Is that Mr. Aero HD? Is that you? Wait, let me get my race chair. The rig is serious, you know, this is some serious business. There it is. Check that bad boy out. Doesn't really. I mean, oh, it's squeaky. It's comfortable. It's a bit tight, but it's comfortable. Oh yeah. So I mean, I've got a little bits here and there. So I've got the wheel, got the seat. The sim rig's coming. The wheels are coming. Don't you worry. It's happening. Luis Rizzo, the Dark Lord sends you a small birthday gift from the Shadow Realm 666, Number of the Devil. Well, many thanks, Luis. I won't spend it all at once in the Shadow Realm. Right. Okay, so. So, yeah, things are coming, things are happening. So, I mean, my main. Wait, well, I can't hear anything. Because my headset's not on. So my main concern really was that with the controller I've kind of plateaued a bit. I think it is time to get the wheel. It is time to start this game on the wheel. So the days of chase cam controller noobing are numbered. As much as I, you know what, I love controller. I love chase cam. It's what I'm used to from a kid, since being a kid on Gran Turismo 1, Gran Turismo 2, all the Gran Turismos. On 5 or 6, which I've never played. I mean, I love the controller. I love it. And I really enjoy playing this game like this, but my main aim for next year is to try to qualify for the World Finals, or at least the Region Finals. And I think I need a wheel to do that. Steve-O. Have half a Five Guys burger on me. My birthday is Saturday. We're plus or minus 1 day birthday twins. That's a thing, right? Well, it is now. It is a thing now. Plus, we may well have been born. I don't know what time of the day I was born. I think I was born quite early in the day. I think I was born like 9 a.m. So my dad went to work I was a weird one because I was actually born at home. I wasn't born in a hospital. So my dad left for work, and then quite soon after, he got the call that you have to come back, your son's been born. So I was a bit too quick for my mum. She just could not hold on. I was like, come on, I've got a live stream to do, mum, get on with it. So I think I was born quite early in the day, but we just call ourselves birthday bros within give or take a day. Pestilence. Mr. Error, I'll get to pestilences one in a second. Is it your birthday, you cheeky hecker? Mr. Error, you little legend. Not today, but Friday. We're nearly there. I'm nearly a Christmas baby. Which I never quite liked when I was younger. I never really liked that. Pestilence is saying sim assembly video. I'm not sure how I can make that into a valuable video, but maybe a live stream. I don't know if you watch Gamer Muscle, but his live streams, he does that a lot on his live streams. He did a live stream like a week ago or 2 weeks ago where it's just him cleaning his sim room. That's it. So he's got a load of sim rigs. It's just him tidying them up. That's it. That was the stream. But I mean, like 200 people were tuning in for that. So I mean, there's potential for something along those lines. But cheers everyone for all those. I mean, I'm barely keeping up here. Right, here we go. Third on the grid, even though that lap wasn't that great. This race is going to be an absolute mess. Absolute mess. We've got four Brits, first to fourth. That's good news. The Wall of Britain. You would watch, okay. I don't know, I don't have a good camera, like, just... So obviously my webcam here is okay, but it's not... When I go to this, it's like, you can see everything, but it's not like the best quality in the world. I'm the only SS member here. You see on your bonnet, it's got the number one, meaning that I've got the highest sportsmanship rating in the lobby. S. But they break it down obviously by a number between 1 and 75,000. And mine's like 53,000. So based on that, I should win. But we'll see. This car is a nightmare to drive. It's so slidey. So slidey. Why is this car only come in white? Yeah, with race A, they typically only let you use a hire car. They don't let you use your own one for some reason. I have a feeling you would get the usual turner even if you were just cleaning your bathroom. I mean, we'll have to work something out. I mean, I know you'd get a few hundred viewers in here, I reckon, which is pretty interesting. But I mean, I've got a big rig coming, and that would take hours to put together. So, I mean, we could do something. Good to be here. Who is your favourite race of all time? Oh, that is a good question. I love Kimi Raikkonen in his peak. Mid-2000s, I think him, I'd say he's my favourite. Not now, obviously I love Raikkonen, but supporting Raikkonen when he was at McLaren, that's what really got me into F1. So I'd say the mid-2000s Raikkonen. He's the driver I've supported the most. ever. Oh, man. What the... Oh, man. That was... I don't even know what to say about that. Just about everything. Is YouTube my full-time job? Well, this is something I was going to say in last week's stream. And yes, it is. It is now. But it hasn't been for long. You probably know... You probably noticed with the increased amount of videos, like normally one day now. So what's your verdict on that one then, guys? Guilty? Should I be banished to the realm? It's a weird one, that. This is why I don't normally trek into Daily Race A. Because I'll just kill everyone. Well, I'm serving a little bit of a penalty. I suppose this would be an easy way to pick up wins, just get good at this race. Not many people can turn up to this one, and they never normally do. But oh, my SR's going to go down again. Oh man, I need to do race B like 8 times in a row. How's your pizza fund coming? Should I just buy a pizza? I honestly would not mind that. I'm trying to eat healthily and then I do a live stream and everyone just sends me to get Five Guys or pizza. And it all goes down the drain. I'm like a second off the pace. Do you watch WTF1? No, not really. I mean, I watch F1. No, I mean, I've not really got into their videos, to be honest. Not, I don't know, it's not for me. Maybe I ought to do my own podcast, you know. Controller cam. Yes, a couple of people asked about that, like, should I have a camera on my... I've always found it a bit weird with the controller, because you can't really replicate what I'm doing just by looking, but I suppose if you're curious and want to have a look, then why not, I suppose. It's kind of so twitchy. I mean, oh god. Marcel, thanks for donating €2, mate. Very nice of you. I suppose my main objective right now is just... I'm not going to get the leads. Just... Oh, man. What is going on? Looks like there's a delay in the steering. I just build up enough of a gap so I can get this penalty down. Pestilence. And be cool once again. Go with that one. Congrats on the new gerb. So does this make us bosses? Your bosses. Thanks for all the awesome content. Yeah, I suppose, yeah. You are my customers. My... They're don't know how you define that one, but thank you very much. And it is quite a dream, really, isn't it? Becoming a full-time YouTuber. I mean, it's not as easy as it looks, I will say that. There's a lot of, not stress, but like a lot of work that goes on behind the scenes. But I mean, not that I want to go back to my old job. Let's put it that way. There was another donation there, sorry, I just cut you off. I'll go back to that in a moment. Okay, I should be good because I've got a 2.9 second gap and I've got a 2.9 second penalty, so it would only take about a second to serve that penalty. It's alright. Super GT 24 hour stream. Oh. Well, that's a challenge. That would be the toughest stream I've done yet, and I've done some pretty tough ones. I mean, that 14 hours... I mean, the 14 hours is okay, because... Well, it's not okay, it's still bloody hard, but you can fit it... You can fit it in between sleeps, so you can wake up, do it, and then go to sleep. So it's okay in that sense. But 24 hours, yeah, that's tough. You have to deprive yourself of sleep, which I am not a fan of. Have a birthday pint on me. Oh, well, that's very kind of you, Paul Connolly. What's your tipple? Normally... Could hear the music again, then, but no, nothing came up. If I'm going for a pint, normally Cronenberg is what I would go for, but I'm not too fussy, to be honest. And it's going to be a second after murder. Oh, I just said a penalty. Said someone else asked if you RKO'd a manager when you quit. This deserves an answer. I did a Stone Cold Stunner, yeah, and the People's Elbow, but I didn't do an RKO. I mean, that's a bit too far. Oh, let's take this off. Oh, yeah. Oh, 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 oh.
Peggy 18.
Second. How much is a pint? In London, you're looking about £5, which is what, $6-$7. Outside of London, it depends where you are, but anything between, at the moment, normally £3 to £4. It can go down to £2, depends on what it is. Anything between £2 and £4, normally about £4, £3 something. Okay, I'm not doing that race again. Does he stream directly from PS4 or does it go through a capture card? Okay, yeah, so if you look in the description, I've linked all my setup, so you can have a look at what I use. But the setup I use is, and yes, we have got time for this, it's good news. Okay, I'm going to restart the game again, just to make sure. But I use an Elgato HD60 Pro. So that inserts into your PC, and then you plug your Xbox, or you plug your PlayStation into it, and you plug your screen into it, like HDMI going into one into each, and then it all goes through my PC. So you could also use the HD60 and the HD60S, both of those would work. Wait, I've got it all here. All my boxes. So many boxes. Stephen Donner from Norwich. Don't get lost in the Shadow Realm. We've got some character development here. It was just Steve, but now he's got Donner with him. Thank you very much, Stephen Donner. Okay, right, we're back. So, where is it? Yeah, this is it. Right, let me load this race and then I'll do it in the loading screen. VW. Okay. Okay, so this is what I used to use, Hasty 60. So imagine normally you, if you're not recording, you just have the HDMI going from your screen into your console, that's it. And then obviously your power one, but that's separate. So when you have one of these, instead of going from console to your screen, you go from console into this, and then from this into your screen. So this just goes in the middle, and you need an extra HDMI cable, but you get one with it. So I used to use that, but now I use this. You see that? HD60 Pro. So that one goes actually inside the PC, but you still plug into it. And also now using the Elgato Stream Deck, which is really useful. And then you've got the Elgato GameCatcher HD, but this is for like Xbox 360. That's what I would use on the older consoles. So I'm loaded up with Elgato, not because they sponsor me or anything, but because their products have just done a good job for me. Does Elgato produce too much input lag when you're playing? So it doesn't affect how I play the game. And also, I could play off of my monitor, the computer monitor, because there's no delay, there's like zero input lag. So I could play off of my computer screen. Like, it's that quick. But yeah, I've just blatantly sponsored, well, I've blatantly advertised Elgato. I should actually get a sponsorship from them. Give me stuff. Oh, wait. I need to go back.
Peggy
to
18.
Oh, why is the Peggy 18 still there? Right. We're back. Hopefully, the race will load this time. Yeah, not sponsored, but maybe I should be because it's just free advertising for Elgato. Oh, well, I mean, sometimes I've done this before. Like, if I think something's good, I'll just say, this is what I use, it's good. It's like, it's a simple case of that. It's no advertising, really. Well, it is, but it's not sponsorship. So for those of you who just joined, this is the new Tokyo Circuit, Tokyo Expressway South Inner Loop is the full name. And I actually, I really like this track, I think it's a very good track. You could say that the surroundings and the colours and everything, it is a bit dull, but in terms of the circuit, how it is to race and how it is to drive, I think it's a very good track. I really like it. And I hope you do too. Are you meant to shift this car early? Yes, so about 3/4 of the way across. That's where you're supposed to shift. It's got so much grip, it's got really good straight line speed and really good acceleration, it's just, and the brakes aren't too bad, so it's just like no weaknesses with this car. I don't know about the tyre wear, I haven't raced it properly yet, so that could be a factor. We will have to see. Three temps up. could do a 54 here. I'm on for a 54. 54 is a good lap time. There's time to be gained in the last sector. I didn't take it very well in the last lap. Breaking just after the 150 board here. Pit lane's there on the left. On the foot a little bit late. I can still gain a couple of tenths with this last sector, I think. Especially on the last corner. Okay, it's going to be close to our PB, but not quite on it. Well, nearly. Half a tenth. So that first corner is actually quite easy because there's a big shadow halfway across it, and as long as you've met the apex, you can just accelerate just before you get to that shadow. And on the entry there's a big shadow which you break just after, so just using the shadows to just using them as visual references really. This car is ridiculously good. It's actually too good, I think. Hey Aries, good to see you, mate. The Tokyo tracks are better at night. Yeah, they have a sort of a... Whenever I think of Tokyo, I think nighttime. I don't know, that city is just... It's all about the lights, really, isn't it, Tokyo? I've never been, I'd love to go. Maybe one day. I always think of the lights. Shall we be expecting a Crash Racing stream? Yes. Yeah, so there was the announcement... very recently that Crash Team Racing have a remaster coming out in June, I think the 21st, I think it was. But yeah, I mean, when it's out, I'm on that. Definitely gonna... And it's got online play, which is the crucial thing, I think. So I'm all over that. Because that was one of my favourite games. That was such a good game. Crash Bandicoot series is really good. That game's especially very good. I don't know if anyone played that Crash Bash game, but I really enjoyed that as well. But yeah, let's have a look at my rating again. I think 82. It went down because of that penalty. Oh god, that's really annoying. And this is not a good track for. To build your driver rating because your sportsmanship rating because of the walls, you just get so many penalties. So I do need to avoid penalties as much as I can. Where's Gary Gilmore? Yeah, I haven't seen him today. He might just be lurking. Okay, make sure we've got the soft tyres. Yep. Front balance, although I don't know if that'll be good in the race with the tyre wear. Might put that back down to zero. We'll see what the tyre wear's like in the first stint. Now this track is weird because the pit lane here isn't on the start finish straight, so you've still got like a third of a lap to go before you actually get to the start finish line from the pit lane. It's quite a weird layout. It's like it's unlike any other track. So if you go into the pits and halfway through the race, you're not actually halfway into the race. You're like a bit before halfway or a bit after. Thoughts on Grid Autosport? I haven't played Autosport. I didn't like Grid 2. And Autosport, it looks similar to 2 to me. It's weird because I love Grid 1, but I just did not like Grid 2. And Autosport I haven't played, so I don't know. What controller sensitivity do I use? 3. Colgate is 2SS and then everyone else is DS. Okay. Gary's probably donated so much he can't afford to put the electric on. Yeah, wouldn't surprise me. It's not just my stream either. He's donated a lot to pretty much every Gran Turismo Sport live stream. Okay, here we go. Momos. On guard. Tuck in that slipstream. Just make sure we don't get killed by DS people back there. Oh, God's sake. Please don't give me a penalty for that. Might be better to stay behind and just short shift. Andy, thank you for the fiver. When is the Lego Racer stream? That was a game. I love that game. I love that game. That was a really good game. I used to play that with my brother all the time. We used to get really competitive over that. I mean, I'd love to play some retro games. I would like to set up my... improve my setup for the classic consoles. God, we're already 5 seconds ahead. He's taking it easy on the fuel. You can't break the toe, mate. I'm going to follow you every inch. Get a penalty, mate. So I'm just saving fuel at the moment. Patient in this one. It's a two horse race and we're 12 seconds ahead now. It's not even close. It'd be like that, I think it's a 2005 American Grand Prix where only six cars left the grid, only raced six cars at Indianapolis. So it's like the two Ferraris miles ahead and then like Jordan and Minardi fighting for the other podium. God, look at him, he's fuel saving like hell there. He was right off the gas. of lag. So I don't, I mean, he might be, he is fuel saving a lot. It'd be interesting to see how much by. Really deep. Okay, I'll take the lead then. I know he's gone in the pits. He had 62. Okay, we had a very similar amount of fuel. Very similar. Okay, so putting a good lap now. Let's go for it. I don't know if he meant that. It looked like he made a mistake, but I suppose if you are going in that pits, you do have to adapt your line going in there. So ideally, when you're going to the pitch, you don't want anyone in front of you because of the way that corner is, you could take a much quicker line because you don't have to take it as a hairpin if you're going to the pits. It only becomes a 90 degree corner. So it's time to be safe there by taking it a little bit differently. He's going to get the undercut on me though. He might be in traffic. Oh no, he's not. So he's actually come out in second. My monitor that gap is just under 11 seconds. It's actually gone up now, 11.1. Okay, this one's going to be very interesting, very interesting. So we've got to work out a line here. I can normally break in just after 150, I'll probably break in a tiny bit later. And just fling across. Oh god, not like that. Back on soft tyres. Well, that wasn't an ideal entry, but... Oh god, there he is. Because that was very close. Okay, you need to get back into slipstream range. Might have overfueled a tiny bit, but got enough for four laps. This is what I need. Come back here, Frenchman. Yeah, it was a horrible entry. I still think he would have been ahead of me, but it was a horrible entry. Shocking. He needs to be a lot braver into that turn. I've just caught up that entire gap. So I'll do a boost fuel saving now. He did lift going into that turn. I've had enough, I'm going for it. Break away from him. Oh, he's jumped right off there. Let's try and put the pressure on, getting this gap open. Thank you. This car's just so planted, it's so controllable. God, what's he doing? Is he... He must... I don't know what he's done there. Unless he's really horribly underfueled and he's having to severely fuel save. And that gap's opening right up. I don't know what his plan is here. If that's if he's got one, maybe he hasn't. Just make sure I don't get a penalty, nothing stupid. Gap is opening right up. He's done something. I can't even explain this, I'm puzzled. Four seconds to gap, and one for a purple lap here as well. Actually, we're going to come up to lap people in a minute, Jesus. Laps. So yeah, I think people in the comments are saying that this race is dominated by this car, and it is. But I'm only going to do one race in this car, and then we'll give it some others to try. Okay, I will need to fuel save a little bit more. But I have got a 4 second margin. A new fastest lap there, 56.1. Everything's under control at the moment, just the fuel might be a bit marginal. I can afford to save a bit of fuel here, go down to mix 3. Short shift. We're in control, we've got a 5 second gap, and I can take it really easy on that last lap about two. I just don't understand what he's done. I might even watch the replay just to work it out. What the hell he was doing. Because that is really weird. We were so even for the first half of the race and then just dropped right off. Yeah, there's a fuel mix, fuel message. Just going to block the screen for this last lap. Get to the end, no penalties. And we're gonna lap someone. In fact, we have lapped someone, really. Okay, we've got 1.1 laps of fuel left. Should be okay. Should be good. Oh, so good when they're ghosted. So good. Scott Priest. Hello. What have you missed? Thanks for the 5, mate. Okay, so the first race, Alpha 4C at Suzuka, it was kind of a rubbish race. I started third, raced awfully, finished third. Then I tried to do this race, but then the game crashed. Then we did the race A, the Ready Fugu Z, Tsukuba. I murdered someone, got second. And then now we're here. So you haven't missed too much, actually. So I'm just baffled. Like, what has this guy done? Why is he now 8 seconds off the lead? Why is he? This makes no sense. Unless he didn't fuel, or he didn't change his tyres. That's the only explanation. I'll have to have a look at the replay, I think. Okay, I'm good for fuel, that's alright. We're gonna win. Nice. There's only one person to race against, but there we go. I mean, to be fair, we could have done that in a much crapper car. Just trying to work out what is a good car around here. Trenton, good to see you again, mate. Rear-wheel drive, front-wheel drive, or all-wheel drive in a real car? Well, I mean, the dream really is a rear-wheel drive car. That's where the real fun is. I would say. If you want to have fun in a car, rear wheel drive. I suppose four wheel drive, you could say. My answer is rear wheel drive for that question. Get in there, Lewis. Miracles do happen, mate. You were sublime out there today. So, Steve, when are you going on Top Gear? That shows, I mean, who's it? Freddie Flintoff and. I can't remember the guy's name, the guy does take me out. It's a weird lineup, isn't it? I mean, we'll have to see how good it is, but. If you're ever up north, let me know and I'll take you out in the Golf R. The Vlog Collab. Vlog Collab, maybe. Yeah, the Golfs. I mean, my friend used to have an R32. My god, that thing. That was ridiculous. It was just too quick. And this is how you rack up easy wins. Get your driver rating down, and then you come up against all the DS noobs. Okay. Thanks for the race. That was a good race. Not. Paddy McGuinness. That's the name. Let's quickly have a look at that replay, see what the hell that guy was doing. So it made no sense. I mean, my strategy was to annoy him by fuel saving right behind him. He fuel saved as well, because when he went in the pits, our fuel amount was exactly the same. And he did go in a lap earlier as well. I mean, we just got to see what he did in that pits. What did he do? And yeah, I was gaining a lot through the triple right. I noticed that as well. Someone said that. Kirk Johnston saying that, yeah. He didn't get his braking point right. I kept going up the inside. I hit him like three times going to that second corner. Making a Shadow Realm livery. Any suggestions? Ben Sterling, thanks very much, mate. I mean, it's a weird one. Someone asked me about it. Actually, it was Pestilence, because he was asking, where did this Shadow Realm thing come from? And it comes from Yu-Gi-Oh, but I've never watched Yu-Gi-Oh. It's just, obviously, someone said it, and it just got into my head. And then, but I've never actually watched the programme. Can you see the fuel amount? You can. Yeah. Let's go to the end of lap three. That's when he went in. He's about to go in here. So you can see there is fuel at the bottom left of the screen. It's about just over 60% here. So his entry wasn't that great, but mine was worse. So he goes in with 62. With his Kinder livery. I love Kinder chocolate. Oh yeah. And he comes out. He didn't put anything in. He must have accidentally pressed the do not refuel thing. Oh, excuse me, God. I mean, yeah, you could have like on the side of the card just shadow realm, and then like some sort of dark purple, black clouds, something along those lines, I'd say. But yeah, once you make it, it depends what card you make it for, but let me know. And let's fast forward to when I come out of the pit, which is going to be here. So he didn't pit. He didn't put anything in. It didn't look like he did anyway. So then I'm going to come out here. There I am. And he's like, oi, hello. So at this point, he's on 50%, 1 mile. Yeah, you see I've got like 10% more fuel. If you just look at that meter at the bottom. So he just didn't fuel. He didn't fuel. I snorted there. Maybe I am a pig. I restart because I watched the replay. Yeah, he bottled the... I mean, to be fair, I've done that a couple of times. Like, you're trying to save time and you just press X like a couple of times and you're like, oh, I told it to not fuel. And like, I need fuel. Okay, we're gonna do that race again, but we'll use a different car because I don't want to use the same car again. I like it when everyone uses one car, because the job then becomes what car can we use to beat that car. And I mean, the Supra might be a good shout, although it doesn't handle quite as well. It's just the Volkswagen is so planted; it's easy to use on a street circuit. Aston Martin. I'm gonna go Aston Martin. Let's see what this is like. See if I can commandeer the big British boy to victory. He filled his car with diesel. Yeah, he put the wrong fuel in. Or is it an electric car, and he had to sit there for 8 hours and wait for it to recharge? Maybe he planned two stops. If he planned two stops, then that was stupid of him. I mean, possibly, but that is a definite one-stop race. That is a one-stop race. Just wondering, would you like these PD in-house tracks in other games like Tokyo Speedway and Assetto Corsa? Well, to be fair, I mean, I really like these tracks. Not that I don't think they would ever make their way into another game. But, I mean, something like Dragon Trail, I mean, that's just a great track. Seaside and gardens, but yeah, a lot of these tracks, I really like them. The fictional ones, I think they're very good. But the Supra in the queue, yeah, the Supra, I think, is a, I mean, that's the car that dominated around the what's it called, Nürburgring Nordschleife 2 weeks ago. That could be a very good car. We could give that one a go. That's on the list. See what the Aston Martin's like. It's a car I've always liked, but I put it in like the second tier for this class. In Group 3, you look at the Volkswagen, the Supra, the 911. Those are the top cars, plus a few others. Track depending. This is probably like in the next group down, sort of good but not the best. Good in capable hands, which hopefully I will have today. My hands aren't cold, but I can't use that excuse. And of course, you've always got a chance if you can stay in the slipstream, because it's got so many straights, this track, actually. What do you think about Toyota putting out of racing games? I mean, have they? I mean, I know, yeah, they're not in Forza. I mean, it's a shame. You want to see as many car brands as possible in racing games. I mean, I'm not a person who's like, but let's say the Supra was taken out of the game or something. It's like, okay, I'll choose something else then. I'm not too fussed, but at the same time, you want to see as many cars as possible, different brands being represented. So, yeah, I mean, it's a bad thing that less brands are in the game. Okay, this Aston feels okay, actually. It's actually quite nifty for such a big car. I just don't know if it's got quite the power of the Volkswagen. And just as I say that, I smash into the wall. The Tenza was very good at the Interlagos race. It's just a little bit sketchy coming out of corners. That's the main issue. And sort of just overall controllability around this kind of track is very important. How's the Ford GT? That's a good shout, actually, yeah. Oh god, look at that. Okay, so at least my rating has gone up now. Let's actually have a look at my rating. 89, okay. So I'm surrounded. I've got four Volkswagens either side. Well, let's see if we can finish there. Be an interesting race. Key's in there at the front. Not expecting to beat him, but you never know. Right, just analyze. Just look at the lap times there. Fortunately, the guy behind me is half a second off. That's quite a good sign. What you don't want is like five people, their lap times, the five people behind you on the grid, you don't want their lap times to be basically the same, but it's a tiny bit slower, because it just means they're as fast as you. Ideally, they're miles off the pace. Like even the guy in 8th and 9th, they're like a second off. We'll see how this goes. But, I mean, I do like this challenge of trying to beat the best car in something else. We'll see how it goes, I suppose. As long as I can stick in the slipstream, I should be okay. And just got to nail those turns. Fuel saving to be done, which I don't think I did too badly last time. Fourth gear for that turn. It's just like instant 5 second penalty if you hit the wall. If you hit it quite hard, it's like 5 seconds. You suck it to your advantage and short shift, Lewis. Gotcha, Toto. Oh, I'm up to fourth now, someone's quit. I've gained a position. How much do you tweak with your cars? Well, this game is... A lot of people ask this, like, what tune do you use? It's balanced performance, the game does the tuning. So the cars are all supposed to be balanced. They're not, but you can't tune the car. Not in this race, anyway. Would you ever get a green screen? I'm not completely against the idea, but I don't really see the point too much. I think it's okay with this background. Okay, here we go. surrounded by the Volkswagen. So what we can do. Yes, I've got the slipstream. Oh no, I'll move back again. Move over this way. Help me. Give me the slipstream. We're both fighting for that slipstream. That VW is quicker in the line. You can see that as we went into that turn two there. Pulling away, that's always a good sign. It's good to know. Don't need the radar now. Oh mate, don't go defensive into there. Keep up with the guys ahead. Hey, unlucky mate. Give up. Oh, classic. 5 second penalty. Get wrecked. Gotta laugh, gotta laugh. I'll get a 5 second in a minute. You can have the left hand sides. Look at that. It's ridiculous. Still there. This is an over. As long as I'm still in that slipstream, I'm good. And I am. I reckon key in the lead is fuel saving quite a lot. So you might think, oh, I'm keeping up with them, but you don't know how much they're fuel saving. Watch out, mate. Hit the wall. Oh, got in second, got 5 seconds now. This track is brutal on penalties. Brutal. But I could get second if I keep up with them. But I'm worried about my fuel, that's the problem. Going for the move on each other now. Okay, he's just increased his penalty. Guy in second now. Okay, it's actually not worth passing because that car will just come back past me again. Anyone going in? No. I mean, this race is just a pit at the end of that four kind of job, pit halfway through. 8 divided by 2 equals 4. I think he's doing the sensible thing. He's not really trying to extend that gap. He's trying to win it on strategy in the pit stop by fueling less. These guys are all over the place. Bit of a silly move to be fair, because he's just going to come back past me now. We are fighting too much. This is really annoying me. How much we've lost to second. It's really unnecessary. Mate. What are you doing, mate? Okay, I wasn't too bad on fuel compared to the other guys. Not too bad. Okay. Ooh, okay, he's tightened up a little bit there. And there was a guy who didn't actually pit. The guy who was in fifth, he stayed out, which is interesting. Ah, come on. So we've got someone else to catch here. So in fourth, I could still get third because the guy in the lead hasn't pitted. Job really is just to try and keep within range of the guy in third there, and he's got a penalty to serve still. Oh god. Interesting one, see if that guy in the lead can actually hold on. Or if he's actually going to pit a lap later, which is a weird strategy, but we'll see what he does. Is this guy going to go for it or not? Oh no, he's gone into the pits now, it's okay. Back into third. Just really just trying to keep up with this VW ahead. He's got a 5.8 second penalty with a 2 second gap. Just trying to estimate how long that penalty will take to serve. I mean, he's probably going to lose. To serve that, he'll probably lose at least maybe 3 seconds. Hard to say. I need to get another penalty, really. Oh, this guy behind's got a bigger penalty as well. Okay, I'm having a good drive here. It's just this car, I can just see the how much slower it is on the straights. And I think on fuel it's a little bit worse. Look how much they gain. It's ridiculous how quick they gain. I've actually caught up on this lap so far. I know his penalty's down to 3.4, okay. It's not as big as I thought. I'm gonna have to gain more, or he's gonna have to get another penalty, I think. It's hard enough to gain against a VW around this track. It's the best car. They've got a half a second advantage of that. No more mandatory slow zones, not in daily races, only in FIA. Oh no, taking that awfully. When will they do the new system in dailies? Yeah, that's a good question. I'm not sure. I think they did say on one of the updates on their website. I can't remember when they said it would be. I think they might have just said soon. Increasingly as though third place would be the result that I'm going to get. Key's just gone. He really fuel saved that first stint. As long as you keep track position in the lead, then just fuel save the hell out of the car and then just do all the work in the second stint. And that's exactly what he's done. And actually the guy ahead's got rid of his penalty completely now. So I will have to gain on him, but it's looking unlikely. The guy behind 6.3 still. Okay, one lap to go. How's fuel? 1.1 laps. One now. Should be okay. Should be good for fourth. Even if he catches up, he's got a big penalty, so don't think he'll be getting past me. Low on fuel, yeah, I can tell. No, actually, I wish they'd make it a little bit clearer. I think they could make that text like font size 72 rather than font size 16. I wouldn't be completely blinded by it. just about okay for fuel. It's close, but I'll be alright. There we go, we'll be third place. Which isn't too bad, actually. I mean, I reckon I would have been second if I had the VW. But I didn't have the VW, I had the V12 Vantage. Comic Sans text, oh no. Comic Sans bold, font size 72. Like, the word art, really massive font, capital letters. You need to pit, you're short on fuel. Did you know? Yeah, like, the whole screen goes red. Yeah, like when you're dying on a shooting game. When you're down on Gears of War, and you're like, the whole screen just goes like blood. And it goes really wavy. You're short on fuel. There we go. Aston Martin, I mean, podium against a load of VWs, not too bad. I'll take that. I'm not sure what can compete with a VW. We'll try the Supra, maybe. The Supra could do good. Look at those VWs. At least I got in and amongst them. I'll take that. I will take that. The highest other car, which isn't a Volkswagen, was the RCF down in 14th. That's ridiculous, isn't it? The last four are all other cars. They're all Volkswagens, apart from me. Sickening joke. Oh, cheers, Key. Yeah, it was a good race, and he did very well, of course, to dominate that one. VW invasion. Coach 231, can you say hi to me for no reason? Hi to me for no reason. Okay, right, next up. 7 minutes. Do this race again. I mean, the Group 4 one at Suzuka is like, it's a cool race, but I don't know. I like this one. This one's much better. Well, apart from the fact there's bloody VWs everywhere. Let's see what other people have done. GTR, 154.9. That's not a bad lap. We could give the GTR a go. I want to give the Supra a go, though. The problem is I don't know how good it is on fuel. And it is quite tricky to drive, but let's give it a go. Okay, so the Supra was really good at the Nürburgring. So let's see if it's good here. See what my... So I got up to 99 again, 54,000. So my driver rating, I tend to peak around 55,000. That's about as high as I can get. But whatever. I love this livery. Real men drive DualShock. Yeah, that's right. Here it is. Real men driving this. Terrible on fuel and tyres. That was my worry, actually. Not enough disc space to save replay. Okay. That's alright for now. Well, let's give it a lap. Let's see what the pace is like, at least. I need to really short shift in this car as well. VW gets about almost 170 down here, miles an hour. What's this going to get to? 165, yeah, a couple of miles an hour short. Good on the brakes though. Oh, I just braked too early. Ah. Oh. Yeah, so I think, oh, bring back Goodwood Hill Climb, or the Goodwood Circuit. GT used it with the Red Bull a few years ago. Yeah, wasn't that, I didn't play Gran Turismo 5 or 6, but wasn't that track, wasn't Goodwood in Gran Turismo, one of the 5 or 6? I'm pretty sure it was. Can you imagine a race on that? 20 players, Goodwood, Goodwood course, A to B sprint, like 1 minute race. But yeah, that'd be good if they could bring that track back. It's perfect for time driving. Is VR worth the money? I haven't actually got VR, so I can't truly recommend it, but I have used VR and it's a very good experience. It is a lot of money though. It's hard to really recommend whether it's worth the money or not. It is a lot of money. But I did enjoy it every time I've used it. Okay, 56.3. Let's see what we can do here then. Break it a bit later into this turn as well. Very good on the brakes. It's really sketchy on throttle. Six temps up, which is only going to be a mid 55, so we need to gain a bit more time. If I can get a low 55, I'll be happy. Second up now. Just gonna let the low 55 rain for them. That's a good lap. 1.2 seconds up. It's gonna be a 55. I know, it'd be a 54.9. Okay, the pace is good. The pace is there in this car. It's just a matter of it's just a matter of fuel saving and tyre. That's the main concern. So if it was race B, it wouldn't matter because there is no fuel, there is no tyres or tyre saving. But race C, you do have to factor that in. Something to think about. Oh man, it's just getting on the power. It's hairy. It's hairy. Why do I short shift? The car is just quicker. It's not much more explaining to do than that. It's just simply faster. If you there's no ghost to compare myself to, unfortunately, but if you put yourself next to a ghost, one revving all the way up, one short shifting, in this car, the short shifting ghost would get ahead. It's just the way it is. Some cars are like that on this game. It's just faster when you short shift them. feels better than the Aston. So I did okay in the Aston just now. What's my favourite food? Oh, I mean, you can't go wrong with pizza, really, can you? Pizza's out there because you can put anything on it, including pineapple. Wait, what? No, pizza. It's got to be pizza. Closely followed by tangy cheese Doritos. Lol, juke. Pizza, I'd say. That instant 5 second penalty. Pestilence! When you start using the wheel and they can see you using it, they will still ask if you use a wheel, yeah. I mean, that question does baffle me. Because I'm keeping my arms remarkably still if I was using a wheel. If I was using a wheel, like, you'd just see it. You'd see the arms. Like, unless I'm just... I don't know. But yeah, you're right. This is why I need to have that FAQ. I need to set up an FAQ. I can't even talk. Jesus. God, ninth. Bloody hell. This is a good grid. Well, it gives us something to aim for. We've got a Mustang behind us. Let's all root for the Mustang and the Supra. Come on. And there's a Peugeot in there. So I'm starting ninth. Actually, I prefer this to be starting a little bit further back because there's more people to overtake. And GTP Twisty is actually number one in the world for the qualifying times with this. So we've actually got the number one player in the world at the moment in here. Footwheel, yeah, I'm using my feet for everything. This will be a happy race. This will be a chaotic race, I think. This one's going to get a bit heated. Okay. Just like to take his time, doesn't it? Quite close in qualifying. Even down to 14th, it's a 54. He's only 2 tenths slower than me, 14th. Just my weekly Monday, five. Just my weekly Monday five, although might be ending soon. Got a kiddo on the way. Don't blame you, mate. I mean, thank you so much for the donation. But yeah, put it towards your kiddo. Dainzel, 156. What's he saying? What is Mr. Dainzel saying? Tokyo track on GT4 was my jam. R246 was a great circuit. Great track that, mate. Cheers, Ben. Cheers, Dainzel. Tokyo R246, what a track. Although, to be fair, I really like this track. I do really like this track. It's just the scenery is a bit dull. It's very grey. They could improve that, but I suppose putting it at night would make it interesting, but then can you imagine how dirty it will get? It's hard enough when you can actually see everyone. Why is the Volkswagen so much better? It just has amazing top speed. It's very nimble without any drama. It doesn't oversteer, doesn't understeer. Very good top end. Fuel is... It has no weaknesses. It's very good at a few things, and it's just not... It has no weaknesses. I'm not even on the screen. I'm so far back. I'm eighth now. It's always someone quits. But the qualifying times here are really close. Really, really close. So it's not going to be an easy race. I could go backwards. Right, here we go. Off we go. Pestilence, is someone getting shagged in the other room? I can't hear anything. I hope not. I don't know. Can anyone hear anything? I can't hear anything. Oh, is that my pawn playing on the other tab? Whoops. No, that, I actually don't know. I can't hear anything. Well, here we go. Oh, they're killing each other. Take the racing line, mate. Everyone's full saving already. So I'm going to go for that pass. I'll take it then. I'll have it. I didn't mean to say. Oh, there's Carnage up there. That's Key. He's being pushed. Do not go for that gap. Do not do it. Supra's coming through, baby. I'm in sixth. Also, the main strength of the VW is that it's convertible, which is worth about 8 seconds a lap. Okay, there we go. Lap one. Gone up two positions. Oh god. Come on, stand, slip straight. Sorry, mate. Mess right up there. Oh, Key's gone for a move into that turn. Not the best place. Oh, man. He just grinded him up against the wall. Brutal defence. There's actually a 3 second penalty there. Cheers, mate. Look at the queue of VWs, oh my god. Dieselgate. Oh, you absolute idiots. Who the hell was that? What an absolute joke. What an absolute joke. Oh my god. Got sent to the Shadow Realm. So stupid. Whoever did that. Just let me settle in ahead, mate. I've decided to name my pig after the U. Pig Boy. I like it. That's actually my real name. It's not actually Steve. That's an alias I use. We're going to have to save the replay. Oh, I can't actually save the replay. God damn. I need to delete some replays so I can actually save replays. Maybe I should have just gone in the pits since I was there. That's such a piss take, because at least if I kept going, that would have been okay. But so I had to spin around and lose like 5 seconds. It's just very frustrating. See if we can get some positions recovered though. What happened? Yeah, it's also got a bit bunched at the hairpin and it's got pushed around. I don't even know what happened. I think someone just went for a move up the inside and which was never on. Oh, God's sake. This is just frustrating now. So I could have had a decent result there. I was in a good position. Well, that's game over, isn't it? Oh my God. Yeah, it's weird, but I said Dieselgate. And then I got killed about 2 seconds later. I'm actually in last. That's not good. Oh God. It's the way you want to turn the console off. Right, I'm 16th. I can't finish last. Come on. I'm not finishing last. Not today. This car is actually not bad on fuel. So... I think it would have been okay there if I had been in a good position still. Right, let's catch up, see what we can do. Catching up. I'm not going to be last. Hashtag not last. There we go. Let's try and set a decent map. I suppose that's what you can do. Oh, someone off. 15th. Come on, we can get a few more. Big gang there. Let's get onto the back of them. Oh, no. No. Oh, man, what a frustrating race. Blue flag. 56-1. Still quite a bit off the pace, actually. I think I'm gaining. Just need to stop making mistakes. Oh. Ryan Elvins. Love your content and dry humour. Many thanks, Ryan. Thank you for the donation. Oh, and another one. Oscar, is it ramming time? It might be. Problem is I don't know who caused that incident. I just ram everyone off, then at least I know I've got them in. That's the only answer. Oh, I'm 14th, okay, I'm not last. Cheers, Ryan, cheers, Oscar. Gain on that lap. Come on. It's quite a strong lobby. It's quite a closely fought one. Just a shame I couldn't really be part of the fight. Well, I was for a lap. Is it me who's shifting early? Yes, but this car kind of, that's how it works in this car. It's the fastest way to drive this thing. There's just a group right there, and they're all fighting each other. Come on, kill each other. Do bad things, please. Looking at the map, it's really close at the front. Really close. I am gaining, look at this. Oh, he's into the wall! And he's got himself a 5-second penalty. Oh man. Apex Magnet. Ironically named. Big group up ahead, 9th, 10th and 11th. I just need them to kill each other and that will be golden. Thank you very much, guys. Oh, one of them's got a penalty. Come on. Let's get a top 10. Do it for Britain. Defensive up there. Chin up, yeah. We'll get him next time. Oh, don't do that. Get out of it, stupid game. You stupid game. this could have been a good result, but it's just such a close race at the front. And I could have been at somewhere up there. Not right at the front, but... I'm tempted to run this race again in the same car. Just see what this car could have done. Running out of fuel. 2% left. That'll be alright. I might be able to nab a position here. No, not quite. I didn't serve that penalty very well. I think I could have been fifth in that one. Yeah, it's really strict around that second corner where you've got the little curbs painted on the ground. If you go beyond the line, like 2 second penalty. Do you have your cars tuned? So this game balanced performance. There's no tuning to be done. The game does the tuning for you with the cars. They're meant to be equal, but they're not. But you can't change the tune. Oh man! No, I want to save it. Thanks for the race. Not. Let's play again sometime. Hold on. Whoever that was, fate is going to hit you hard one day. Hopefully today. Oh, man. The thing is, it's like... I want to give that car a fair try. Back to 9-11. Tempted just to run it again. Kia saved it. Nice. Okay, we can watch that sometime then. Cheers, Kia, you're a legend. Yeah, someone on the inside was rammed, but obviously someone was at fault. I don't know who. It might not necessarily have been the guy who was right there. So he seemed to have braked at the right time, and there was someone else behind, I think. Group 4 race is the better race. I'll delete some replays, that's the point. Yeah, let's do that. Full GT. Ooh. GTR. Okay, yeah, the GTR. Library. Got these rack up quickly. Let's go down to the bottom. So at least some of these got some space. That'll do. I want to try cars that might be competitive, and someone's done a good lap in the GTR. We'll give the GTR a try. Not that race, not doing that again. God, I have not busted out the GTR in a while. There's one over there. I swear I've got one with a livery. Where's my one with a livery? Maybe I haven't. Just that one. Seems to be the case. Okay. Was I short shifting for no reason? No, that's the best. That's the quickest way for that car to be driven. Some cars are just like that. You just shift early and it just goes faster. Key's watching the replay. Okay. Wait, can we?
Let's have a little look from his view. Just like when you're in this situation.
Streamception. Watch my crash. Not much sportsmanship going on around here. I don't use the 458. It's just not a good car. It's just not a good car. Right. Oh. TCS is on. Get off. See how this car performs. I haven't used this in a while. I used to use it all the time for the FIA earlier this year, but after that, kind of just not really. Oh, it's a bit off on straight line speed. Into the hairpin of death. It's so frustrating that I was the only one to spin out. Ooh, hello. You should use the 458. I said it a minute ago, it's not a good car. It's not that great. Unfortunately, I know this. Well, I mean, this probably isn't a great car at the moment. You know what? I'm going to use the Supra again. I want to see what it can do. Because I really think that would have been a good race there. Oh, and hard tyre. God, yes. That's a point. I still think that. Oh man. Entry to deadline, 20 seconds. Okay, screw it. Nissan, but we'll put the softs on. Forgot about that. Look at that. The chat rescuing me. Okay, we'll put the soft tires on. I haven't had much practice in that car. I'm going to have to adapt. The GTR is a big boy. It's huge. It is a big boy. But we used the Aston Martin earlier. That's a big boy too. That's okay. How's the new track? I really like it. It's got a mix of everything. It's got fast sweeping corners. It's got sort of technical parts. It's got lots of straights. It's got hairpins. It's got a bit of a mix, and it's good overtaking opportunities as well. I did great with the Supra. I'm sure we would have been top five. I think top five. I was looking at the gap. Like, the top four were, like, they had a bit of a gap, and then fifth place was 12 seconds off the lead. I think I could have been within 12 seconds of the lead. How long do you think the wheel will take to get used to? Yeah, I mean that could take quite. That could take like a few weeks at least, I would have thought, but we'll have to see. Is there tuning for these races? No, no tuning. No tuning. You don't do anything apart from tyres. That's it, or like ABS and TCS, but that's not really tuning. Yeah, the Super does have to have a fair chance. Oh my god, do I have to restart this game after every race? Oh my god. Why?
Peggy 18.
Why? 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 Why?
Peggy 18.
Oh, Peggy 18 back again. Right, where did I put that revolver? Mum, got the rope! Because I watched a replay on Keystream, yeah. God damn it! $20 to cry on stream. Oh, I don't know. Someone offered me like $200 to fart on stream. I think that's a better deal. What if I fart and cry at the same time? I hate. The annoying thing is that this race is at half past as well, and you miss that one. That's like, you can't go back and just join that race. I can do this race again, but it's like, oh, it's a rubbish race. Oscar, you forgot to switch it to Wumbo. What the hell is Wumbo? What is Wumbo? GT Sport committing die. It just went and committed die. Wumbo. Let's have a little lesson today, shall we? Wumbo is widely regarded as the opposite of mini. While mini things are small, Wumbo items are rather large. Wombology is the study of Wumbo and anything that is or of a Wumbo nature. That is or of a Wumbo nature, which was concluded by Professor Alex James Herto in 2003. I Wumbo, you Wumbo, he, she, me Wumbo, Wumbo, Wumboing, and Wumboed are all examples of the use of Wumbo. History of Wumbo. Are we gonna... Famous quotes. Did you set it to Wumbo by the Mermaid Man? Oops, I Wumboed again. I remember that lyric, yeah, from Britney Spears, yeah. I Wumboed in my pants by the Lonely Island, what a tune. Shrek, what are you doing in my Wumbo? To Wumbo or not to Wumbo? That is the question. William Shakespeare. Yeah, that's a well-known quote, that. What is with the Wumbo? It's with the Wumbo. You've introduced me to the world of Wumbo. Thank you so much. I'm a broken man. I'm a broken man. What has the world done? What has the world done to me? In fact, dun 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 dun. man. Can we get some Victoria's Secret adverts? Let's have a look. Let's have a look. Come on. Victoria's Secret. Let's make the stream interesting. Those controllers are really weird. The Raiju Ultimate. Customizable 360 RGB. Come on. Something interesting. Gamis. What the hell is that? It's like Assassin's Creed going on. Morrowind? No thanks. Steam? No. No thanks. Come on. Show me good things. Trading 212? No. No, I don't want to buy that. All that. All that. I want to buy Victoria's Secret lingerie. Come on. GoPro British Grand Prix. That looks interesting, actually. I might actually go to that. HDTV's here. Yeah, I already said I'm going to that. You don't need to show me that again. Stop seeing this ad. Stop seeing this ad. Eventually, we'll get all the ads ever. Piggy? Wait, what is this? What is Piggy? Coupons and cashback. Yes, I'm eligible. Thank you, Piggy. Piggy is loading the most recent version of the Google Chrome Web Store. There he is down there. Right, anyway, right, we've had enough of that. Let's get off that. Ah, right. It's the time. Where's the bacon shirt? Yeah, I ordered a hoodie, a bacon one. Right, I got the email and it said delivery is 15 to 35 days. I was like, what? Are you delivering it from Mars or something? And his name is Super GT. Yeah, there we go, Pestilence. The bacon hoodie, 15 to 35 days. Like, what takes 5 weeks to deliver? Are they based on the South Pole or something? I don't know. Now, while we're here, let's just do this race again. That'll take up some time. Even though it's an awful race. And I said I wouldn't do it again, but I'm going to do it again. And I can't even practice. Boo. Oh, okay. Okay, we have an update regarding the previous incident at the last race. So a guy's messaged me on Twitter, and it was his fault. But, you know, he's saying sorry and everything. So, you know what? People make mistakes. I mean, I've smashed people off. I've done the same thing. So, I don't know. Wait, can we play this? Will you be able to see this? Just sent it. Oh, man, what have you done? What have you done? We've got to watch that again. I mean, he lifted back off. He should have just stayed on the brakes. I'm looking at his brake. Oh, no, wait. I don't know, it was a weird one, it just kind of coasted in there. Oh man, no worries. All around me are familiar faces. One out of faces. One out places, bright and early for their daily races, going nowhere, going nowhere.
All around me are familiar faces, worn out.
Oh yeah. Wait, can I turn that on so I can actually hear it? Media source. Yeah.
All around me are familiar faces, worn out.
I love that. Why not open on Twitter? That's a good point, yeah. Where is it? That is a good point. Let's have a look. Here it is. No, what are you doing? Oh well. He got me good. He sent me to the realm. I look chubby as a kid. There I am. That's me, aged 5. Colorized. No, he's probably like 11. I don't know. All right, here we go. This is the meme race. Oh, where am I? 9th. Okay. This is where my SR goes back down to 0. Let's do good things. Oh, the leader went early there. Give him a penalty. Let's try TCS on for a lap. Oh, look at that, 4 abreast. Love it. Oh, I'm up into 5th from 9th. We're going to win. Car snapped at me there. Just get a TCS off. I don't think I need it. Right, up to 5th. Not bad. I'll take that. Oh, Spaniards off. 4th. Got sucked off. And no, this is not Pornhub. Shifting is so slow. Come on! I can get second here, I reckon. Looks like the white car will win. I don't know. I don't think you're right on that. I reckon the green one will win. That's unrivaled banter right there, mate. I'm keeping up with him. Close one, but it's, sometimes it's really hard to pass in these kind of cars. Especially if you're crap, like I am. Come on. Come under pressure. Open up the inside. Yes, what a move. Come here, Frenchman. Oh, contact behind. I can hear the banging. They are banging hard back there. Oh baby, they're queuing up. How long has the stream been on? Nearly 3 hours. Keep it together. The pole sitter is in sixth. That's not gone well for him. Actually, the lead is just dropping off a little bit there. Come at me, bro. Bring it on. There's only 3 tenths off the leader's pace, in terms of faster lap, that's not too bad. This is one of those races where qualifying is so important. Apart from obviously at the start when I just overtake like 8 people, but normally it's very important. Don't mess up the last turn. I will take that. I'll take a third. Not much happened there, but I'll take it. I'll take it. I mean, it all happened at the start, really. Everyone just killed each other. So, Steve, when's the next Group X Rally Race Open Lobby? My favourite stream of yours ever. Group X? Did we do Group X? I'll have to do that again soon, yeah. When I do an open lobby, we'll do it. We always got to do... It's mandatory to always do at least the... I wasn't sick, but I gained 6. It's always mandatory to do the no rules rally race. Right. Okay. We're coming back to race C. I'm gonna give justice for the Supra. We're gonna close the application just to make sure again that it won't bloody quit. Go back in. That was a podium, yeah, from 9th. It was like 4 abreast through turn 1. I kind of just got them on the way out. So nice and aggressive there at turn 1. Got the job done. Good times, good times. Okay, so yeah, we're going to move back to Daily Race C, Tokyo. We want justice for the Supra. Imagine Super GT on GTA 5. You know what, I was considering kind of making videos on that, or like at least just trying out the racing, because you watch someone like Bruffy. I don't know if you've heard of Bruffy, but he does racing on GTA, and it's not like as bad as you think. Like they have like professional racing series where people, like, they're really good, they're really fast, and it's not actually all about ramming. It is just genuinely about like speed, because if you start ramming each other off, you lose so much time on that game, as you do in any game, to be fair. But it's about time I started ordering some pizza. I am hungry, but I don't know if it's the right time. I do fancy it. Honestly, I do really fancy it. I might just do it. Wait. I might just do it. Domino's. Let's have a look. What day is it today? Oh, they just closed. Wait. What about... Papa John's. Papa Jonas. Let's have a look. What are your opening times? What are your opening times, mate? Monday. Got 5 minutes. I don't know if they'll accept that, though. Nah, we'll leave it for today. Maybe next time. It's too late now, unfortunately. Okay, qualifying time trial. Let's get a bit of practice in for this. Let's let's do some justice for the real men drive with the DualShock car. Pineapple nah or pineapple yeah. For me, I mean, if I was dying on a desert island and someone went, look, here's a pineapple pizza, I'd eat it. But typically I'd say no. I mean there's so many better options for a pizza. There's so much choice for pizza. It's like, why would you go for a pineapple when there's so many other options out there? That's the question. Option 2, dirty kebab. That's a good shout, actually. The problem is I have to go and get that. I have to go and actually walk. That involves actually going outside, and I don't do that. I don't even know what outside is. Cheeseburger sounds good. Or I don't know, I'm getting one on Friday, it's my birthday. I don't know if I should be eating Five Guys every day. Should I just do the Super Size Me but Five Guys version? Just some pineapple now. Yeah, that's right. The problem with it, it's such a contrast on the pizza because it has no... Normally everything on the pizza is hot, but with the pineapple it has a cold feel to it, which is just a sharp contrast. I don't know. Get a Deliveroo. Yeah, that's a point. Get the Deliveroo driver to do this race for me. Super GT hasn't seen the sun in 21 years and hasn't showered in 4. Sounds about right. Give or take a few months, but I think you're right, yeah. Right, no messing around here, let's put in a good lap. Minimum. Let's try and get into a 54.9. Let's go. Not this lap, next one. Itch my nose. Right, let's go. Yeah, that doesn't help. See you later, ghost. I was actually going to go and see The Apprentice. I don't know if you... There might be a US version, but in the UK there's a show called The Apprentice. And I was actually going to go and watch the You're Hired show on Wednesday, but unfortunately they had to change the seating, so that ticket doesn't work anymore. That would have been cool, a little experience. Sadly, no longer going. As a chef, you're wrong. Oh yeah, of course. Well, nah, pineapple on pizza. I mean, I'm not totally against it, but there's just better options. When I'm Prime Minister or President, anyone who thinks otherwise is going to jail. Right, what's the time going to be? It's going to be a low 55. 55.2, okay. That's not too bad. I did mess up some of these turns quite badly. For example, that one. See that? That's already 2 temps gained. So I'm on for a 54 now. Chocolate on pizza. I can't say I've ever tried that. You know what, I think after this stream I am taking a late night drive to Tesco. I do fancy a lot of food right now. I shouldn't do it, but... YOLO, you know? When all things fail, YOLO. Scream YOLO. Okay, here we go. Super Justice. Where are we starting? Oh, 12. Damn, son, where'd you find this? My God, look at that. If I was 1/10 quicker, I'll be eighth. If I was 2 tenths quicker, I'd be fifth. That's unreal. 2 tenths, I'll be fifth. I need to improve that qualifying time. This happened to me last week at Interlagos. I was like, if I improved by 2 tenths, I would have been like 88 positions higher on the grid. I would be a better PM than Theresa. Theresa May is just like, just awful. Just absolutely awful. And what's that robot dance all about? Like, it's just so cringe. Whenever I see it, all I think is,
all around me are familiar faces, worn out.
That's all I can think. Yeah, I mean, that is a close. So you've got a couple of people there. The top three are like, they're like a long way off, but everyone else in there looking like a tasty treat. Hopefully I just don't get eaten like I did in the last one. I'm gonna go and buy a bitch lasagna. TC Reese ain't nothing but a bitch lasagna, bitch lasagna, bitch lasagna. Look at T-Series, they're just crying for the mama. Bitch lasagna, bitch lasagna. T-Series ain't nothing but a bitch lasagna. Look at T-Series, they're just crying for the mama. I'm basically PewDiePie. I taught him everything he knows. Lol. He just got a penalty for slowing down. Bitch lasagna. I love that song. It's like, oh man. Subscribe to PewDiePie. Stop T-Series. I mean, what even is T-Series? How have they got 75 million subs? What's that all about? Super Duty, I'm dropping my mixtape, 2019. Look out. To be honest, like Theresa May is shocking. Jeremy Corbyn is a bit, he's like crap as well. I need to start my own party. I reckon I could become Prime Minister. Like, they are that bad. Like, if all my subscribers vote for me, then that's a start. On tonight's show, on the X Factor, Super GT, and Ollie Murs. Right, let's go. Momo's 91 on his alternate account. Well, I don't know where to break. In the slipstream, playing it safe on the 150. Oh, take that, thank you. Pestilence, the real question is PewDiePie doing his part to. Yeah. Imagine if PewDiePie just went. What? Right, I'm featuring. Oh, that guy's off. He just did a whole video for me, right? Look, guys, subscribe to Super GT. Can you imagine how many? I'll probably get to a million subs like straight away. Hopefully, he makes a Super GT diss track because I'm actually going to catch up with him soon. Thank you. Oh, that's a big gap behind. See ya later. Come on, Super, do good things. Show the ladies and gentlemen what you can do. Let's get that slipstream. Don't need the radar now. Let's go. Do good things. Right, that's it. Slipstream, suck me along, mate. Suck me, German. Oh, I was close. Just had to back out there. Come back here, bitch lasagna. VW drivers ain't nothing but a bitch lasagna. Toyota Master Race. Look at that speed. Unreal. I can't keep up with that. Oh no, don't give me 5 second penalty. Nearly. So many Germans. Is this Deutschland? Get out of my way, Germans. A bad lap time. Oh, he's going wide there. We should lost slipstream. Oh, they are sucking me so hard. And I'm loving it. Peggy, 80. Go on, go for the lunge, that's it. Get out of the way. Yes, come on. Now, there's a big group up ahead. Can we just get onto the back of that group? They are fighting. Oh, mate, they are fighting. Something's going to go wrong at that hairpin. Something is going to go wrong. Should have blocked that. Oh, he's gone deep. He's gone deep. Unlucky, mate. You ain't nothing but a bitch lasagna. Slipstream annoyingly. Yeah, these guys have come back straight past me, I think. T-Series ain't nothing but a... Oh, you absolute idiots! What are you doing? How many times? Oh my god, I've smited him. What the hell? Oh my god. Super GT is a bitch lasagna. He was ghosted there. Then he wasn't.
Peggy 18.
Oh my god. Someone shoot me. I'm definitely going to Tesco now. £3 meal deal, that'll make me happy. This is a joke. This is a sick joke. And I'm the only one who's not laughing. Oh, someone's off. Oh my god. It's the Blitzkrieg. It's the Blitz all over again. Let's get out of here. Let's go. What a freaking joke. Bring back capital punishment. Someone needs to go down for this. Right, okay, let's just do what we can do. Oscar? Yeah, it's true. It happened to me on Forza Horizon. I was trying to promote clean racing, but then I became a wall riding rammer. It happens to the best of us, mate. You can't resist it for long. It will, you know, the dark side will invade you. It will take over your soul at some point. There's nothing you can do about it. Waldy Capita. I'm going to bleach my eyes. Filthy, yeah. Just sit in a bath of bleach for like 24 hours. That should do the trick. That worked for me anyway. There's still some positions here to be... Oh, that guy... Oh, he's going in the pits. It's alright. I thought he did that by accident. Danny Turn. Thank you for what while I recover from surgery. Okay. Well, good luck for your recovery, mate. The doctors have prescribed some Super GT for you. That's good to hear. I can't cure cancer, but as long as I can keep you entertained when you're recovering, that's good stuff. I'm in 10th. Oh, man, this is so frustrating. When are people going to learn how to brake on time? God, hello. Man, I love watching your vids. Super chill. Thank you so much, mate. Yeah, that's the idea. I mean, sometimes they're a mix of serious and joke and relax, you know? So, bit of both. But good to hear, mate. Thank you for the donation. Still got that penalty to deal with, that's annoying. I did kill that guy to be fair, but still annoying. Good move. Just look at that Volkswagen go, it's just so quick. That wasn't very inter... What are you doing? Tsuidi should have just waited, following through this turn then. He got a 4 second penalty for that. That's it, bump draft, mate. There we go. Cheers, mate. God, I went so slow there, it actually ghosted me for a bit. That VW is just so quick. It gains like half a second on every straight. It's absolutely sickening. That's it. Bump draft. Oh, baby. Feel the speed. Oh, yeah. Give me more. Still right there. That's not much. I don't think there's much chance of getting 8. Even if we get past him, we'll still got a big penalty. It's gonna be hard. He's bump drafting. He's in on the deal. Together we achieve more. Come back here, Irish person. He's not going for the move. He's committed to letting me set the pace, albeit with bump drafting. But watch this, like, it was nearly half a second behind there. He's just going to gain all that back. Slipstream assisted, but still, that car is ridiculous. And he's already like right on me. He's going for it now. Oh, we both made it through there. That's good driving. Look at that thing, it's just so fast. Oh, someone's got a big penalty there. Doc Brown's slow for some reason. Has he run out of fuel? Oh no. I mean, oh yes. Oh no. Don't penalise me, please. Ninth. That will have to do. Yeah, so I'm going down every time we take a bump there, which, yeah, can be annoying. Oh, where would we have finished without that contact? We were looking at the back of the group for 3rd, 4th and 5th. I reckon it would have been 6th minimum. Possibly in that group for like 3rd, 4th and 5th, but would have been hard. Mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm. Okay, ninth is six upside down, so that'll do. Let's analyze what happened. How's the Supra? The Supra is a very good car, actually. Obviously, around that track, the VW is the better car, but it's actually a very quick car, the Supra. It's good all round, a good top end. It's just a little bit hard through slow corners to control, but ultimately quite a good car. A very good car. The YouTuber streams tonight have convinced me to not do race C. Yeah, don't blame me, to be honest. It is a bit of a mess. It is a bit of a mess out there. Let's have a look what happened then. What time is it in the UK? It's 11:30 almost. Who was it? Well, let's just fast forward. Let's see what happened to him. Anal Craig. Acorn Naig. I like to call him Anal Craig. Chewy D, he was up here in second. Let's see what happened to this guy. Oh, that's what happened. Was that on? Let's have a look. He made a mistake and then he pounced on it, but. So that's where they both. And I'm like, yeah, I'd say that. Cheers, mate. He goes back up the inside, but he goes deep. I'm back. Right. This is where it happened. Who did it? It was Halbstark. Oh, man. Halbstark, man. Where did he brake? Oh, that was a bit late on the brakes, especially when you get in slipstream. You do have to brake quite a lot earlier. He got both of us. Double kill. Peggy, 18. Right. I am going to wrap up the stream now. Thank you so much for joining. I think it was a good stream, actually. I enjoyed this one.
Peggy, 18.
Even, why does that thing keeps coming up? Even though the races didn't go all that well, but it was good fun. And thank you all for joining. I'll be streaming again very soon, no doubt. We'll work something out. Shame on you, Halbstark. You have brought shame to Germany. I've raised Halbstark a lot. I mean, he's not like that. He's a fair player. He wouldn't do that like on purpose, but sometimes we make mistakes, and I've done it plenty of times, as we all know. But yeah, thank you all for tuning in. What should I say before I go? You might have noticed in the description, so I've got a load of links to all my setup. If you want to ever look at all the setup I have, it's all linked. I've got affiliate links. If you ever buy anything through Fanatec, click on my link first, then buy it. Yes. But yeah, it was a good one. This, for those of you who missed it, it will be a video very soon. So you don't have to worry about that. It will turn into a video at some point. Off to Tesco now. Yeah, go and buy that £3 meal deal and a massive pizza, chuck in the oven. But that's it. We are going to be signing out. and I'm going to actually put the outro in for once. So, guys, thank you so much for joining. Much love, as always. I shall see you very soon.